Hello everybody, how are you today? How was your weekend? I'm glad. Well, today our lesson objective will be pronunciation. We are going to review verbs finished in ed pronunciation, and also we will review words that have the same pronunciation but a different spelling, a very slight difference in the spelling, and of course different meaning, right? Well, so pay attention because today we will engage in something that I'm pretty sure you really like. Well, let's start our topic with the following verbs: loved, danced, and needed. In order, all of you, I would like you to say aloud these three verbs and pay special attention in the end, in the pronunciation of the ED. Okay? Let's see how it comes. Well, guys, it was a tricky exercise, I know. I did it on purpose, so you can put the blame on me. Because this way, I wanted to show you the three types of pronunciations that we have for verbs finished in ed. You can see now in the whiteboard, I have created this graphic to show you the type of verbs, okay, the explanation, then the type of pronunciation, and finally some examples, some boxes with examples of each type of verb. Now we are going to practice with a listening exercise. You can go to your computers and log in, okay, in the page that I have written there. It's an exercise where you need to drag and drop verbs, very easy, but we have three columns for each type of pronunciation, and you will select the verb, drag it, and place it, drop it in the proper column according to the pronunciation. Okay? I'm going to place the record twice so you can recheck the exercise before you finish, and let's correct all together. Okay, here we have the results of the drag and drop verbs exercise. I know it was a bit complicated because this type of difference in the pronunciation is quite slight, so it involves a good listening and also get used to this type of differences. But at least from now on, you will be aware of it and something to consider, right? Now let's do something else to practice so you can continue working on this but at a different level. We are going to work in pairs. I'm going to give you, assign you two verbs per group, and you will need to create a sentence with the using the verb, and then we will practice all together pronunciation. Okay, so let's go ahead. Okay, guys, good sentences. Don't feel bad about the results of the pronunciation. It's just a matter of getting used, practicing and practicing and practicing. From the moment that you are aware of it, you will realize that we'll pay attention every time that you pronounce these verbs, and up to the moment that it will come naturally. Okay? Now let's move on in our lesson plan objective, and I'm going to show you what do you see here in the screen. Good. This is called a tongue twister, okay? And it's the way that I'm introducing to you our next topics that are topic that is related to words that have the same pronunciation but different meaning and different spelling. Let's check it out together. I'm showing you a list where you have some examples of words that have exactly the same pronunciation but different meaning and a very slight difference in the spelling. So you need to pay attention. When you are reading, okay, maybe it's easy to realize. But remember that in a conversation, for example, you will understand the meaning of the word in the context, right? So that's what gives us a hint of what the person is talking about and which of the words is referring to. Now we are going to practice the homonyms with a match with arrows exercise. I've already gave you the handout, so you have to place an arrow to match the word in column A to the word in column B. Remember, they have the same pronunciation, different spelling, different meaning. Correct? Guys, time is over. Let's correct all together in the whiteboard the exercise. I would like you to stand up and place an arrow in the whiteboard so we can see the correct matching. Well, we are going to finish the lesson with a funny exercise. I've displayed 3 tongue twisters in the whiteboard, so you can practice in pairs, right? Let's see how is your progress. If you have any question, let me know. I will walk around to check it, the pronunciation. Let's start.